Hello students, today I am going to start with the first chapter of your syllabus, that is lesson number 5, tense. I am Sanju Singh and I am starting with the chapter. There are three kinds of tenses. First is present tense, second is past tense and third is future tense. There are four forms of the tenses. First is simple, second is continuous, then perfect and fourth one is perfect continuous. I am going to start with the simple present tense. In simple present tense, we have a subject, we have verb, verb 1, here I have written V1, that means present tense, and it will have S, ES or IES depending on the subject, plus it will have an object. For example, if the subject is singular, that can be he, she, it, Ram, Sita, any singular subject, then we will write Ram eats mango. Is that clear? Singular subject will have S, ES or IES. For example, here we are having the verb eat, so we will add S. If the sentence is the baby cries, there we will have IES, and if there the subject is babies, then we will say cry, CRY. In plural subject, we don't add S, ES or IES. In singular subject, we add S, ES or IES in the verb. For example, they eat mango. Here they is plural, and so we don't have to add S, ES or IES as we added in singular subject. Same way, we eat mango. There is no need to add S, ES or IES. It has been added only when the subject is singular. For plural subject, we don't require S, ES or IES. Same way, simple past tense. In simple past tense, we have a subject, we have V2, V2 means verb 2, that is past tense, and an object. Again, here the subject is he, she, it, Ram, any singular subject, then we will write Ram, eat will become eat. Verb 2 means, verb 1 is eat, ate and eaten, that is verb 3 form. So your verb 2 form we have to write, and so Ram ate mango. Here if the subject changes from singular to plural, then also the verb do not change. We ate mango, they ate mango, it remains the same. Now the third case is simple future tense. Here again we have a subject, we have either will or shall, then verb 1 and object. For example, Ram will eat mango. Is that clear? Now if I am having I or we, W-E-V, then I will use shall, not will. I shall eat mango. This is simple future tense. Now moving towards to present continuous tense. Here we have subject, is, am, are, any one of the helping verbs, plus verb 1, plus ing, plus object. For example, Ram is eating mango. If we are having he, then also he is eating mango, she is eating mango. Here all the subjects are singular, and so we are using is. I, when the subject is I will use I am eating mango. When the subject is plural, whether it is they, we, then we will write they are eating mango. For they, plural subject, we will use are. For singular subject, we will use is. And for I will use am. So these are the three cases where the helping verb is, am, are used in present continuous tense. Remember students, for present continuous tense, we have to use is, am, are. right? Now same way for past continuous tense, we will have a subject. We will use was or were depending on the subject. Were 1 plus ing plus object. For example, he, she, it, Ram, any of the subject, singular subject, we will write Ram was eating mango. But when the subject is plural, that is they, we, then we will write they were eating mango. So these are the cases when the subject is singular, we will use was. When the subject is plural, we will use were. Same way for future continuous tense, we will have subject, again will or shall, be, verb 1, ing plus object. For example, she will be eating mango, he will be eating mango, Ram will be eating mango, I or we shall be eating mango. So these are the cases of future continuous tense. Remember students, whenever continuous tense is there, that means the action is going. So everywhere verb 1 plus ing is sure to come. Depending on present tense, we will use is, am, are helping verbs. Depending on past tense, we will use was, were, and future tense, we will use will, shall, be plus verb 1 plus ing. So this thing you have to remember, in continuous tense you will be having verb 1 plus ing. Now present perfect tense. For present perfect tense, we have subject plus has or have plus verb 3 plus object. For example, Ram has, now verb 3 eat, ate, verb 3 is eaten. So Ram has eaten mango. And if the subject is plural, they have eaten mango. So this is the difference where to use has, where to use have. In singular subject you will use has, in plural subject you will use have. Now past perfect tense, you have a subject, you have had, verb 3, and object. Ram had eaten mango. This is for singular. For plural also, we have to use they had eaten mango. So verb do not change, it remains same. Now same way, future perfect tense, you have a subject, will or shall, plus have, plus verb 3, plus object. For example, Ram will have eaten mango. I or we shall have eaten mango. So these are the cases where you have to use will, where you have to use shall. For subjects like I, we use shall, and remaining we use will. So this is for perfect tenses. Now when perfect continuous tense, for present perfect continuous tense, we have a subject, has or have, plus been, plus verb 1, plus ing, plus object. For example, Ram has been eating mango. He has been eating mango. For singular subject, we use has been eating. As soon as the subject becomes plural, that is they, we will use they have been eating mango. Has will change into have. They have been eating mango. This is present perfect continuous tense. Now past perfect continuous tense, subject had plus been plus verb 1 plus ing plus object. Ram had been eating mango. This is for singular. If there is a plural subject, then also it do not change. They had been eating mango. Now future perfect continuous tense. For future perfect continuous tense, we have a subject, verb, that is will, shall, have, been, plus verb 1, plus ing, plus object. Ram will have been eating mango. As I told you, whenever we are having I or we will use shall. In all other cases, we will use will have been. So I or we shall have been eating mango. So these are the 12 cases of tenses. There are three kinds, that is present, past, future, and there are four forms, that is simple, continuous, perfect and perfect continuous. Now when I say V1, V2, V3, I have explained here. See, V1 means present tense, V2 means past tense, and V3 means past participle. For example, eat, past tense will be ate, and past participle will be eaten. Eat, ate, eaten. Give, gave, given. Go, went, gone. So these are the cases how you change from verb 1, verb 2 and verb 3. Now here I am going to give you one exercise. Two examples I am going to solve for you. The first one, you have to change what kind of exercise you have. You don't have King's Grammar exercise, but you have this kind of exercise in exams also. You have to change the tense of the verb according to the brackets given in the sentence. For example, first example, Vinod inspires me to achieve the target. Now which is the verb here? Inspires, and which form it is? Present tense, and you have to change into simple future tense. So what will be the answer? Vinod. See, in future tense what you have used? Will, right? Subject will shall plus verb 1 plus object. So Vinod will inspire me to achieve the target. I hope you are getting it. Vinod, instead of inspire, now I will write will inspire, S will be removed. Vinod will inspire me to achieve the targets. Second example, her illness is reducing her to a bag of bones. Now which is the verb here? Is reducing, that is present continuous tense. The sentence is having present continuous tense, and it is to be changed into present perfect tense. That means has, have. What we have used? Has, have, plus verb 3 plus object. So here you are having her illness is your subject. Is reduced will have change, will be changed into has reduced. Reduced. Has, her illness has reduced her to a bag of bones. So this way you can change the remaining sentence in your homework. This is Sanju Singh signing off. Stay home, stay healthy, take care of yourself and your elders. Thank you.